Okay, and if my job starts so that I need that size of socket, what size is 21 millimeters? Here is 21 is this 21 millimeters, 21 millimeters, and then of course a little bit longer bar that I can open this. Then I insert this my bolt in here in that way. Now I open this first bolt. Okay, and then I do so that I open these all bolts little bit that way. And I don't open those too much, only one rotation, and then I lift that my feel up, because it is easier to open these bolts when this feel and tire is ground. Okay, and then I open also those three other bolts, and then we continue. Okay, and now there is a situation that all bolts are loosened, and then I little bit lift up this car body using this my jack, and we can use some jack or lifting system that we little bit lift up that way. Okay, and we need to lift up this only so much that this feel is in like air. It is like flying. And next I take those bolts away, and I will do that next. Okay, and then I am opening these bolts, and now I can only use this one socket and rotate this. And there is first bolt in here, and now I take all of these bolts away. This is a little bit tight, now it moves, and then I have take all of these bolts away, I can lift that wheel out. Just tie it. Okay, there a second. Okay, and three bolts left. Okay, and now when all bolts are free, I can insert my fingers in here and lift that my feet away. Okay, and my friend is testing her motorcycle, if you hear something motorcycle sound. Okay, and now next step is to take this break room away, and I start to work with that. Okay, then this break room removing, it happens so that normally this break room is always quite stuck, but sometimes we can take that out in this way, that we only insert our hand in here. But this is quite unnormal situation, because normal these break rooms, they are rusty and difficult to open, and that we need next two opening bolts. Toyota, they are so excellent manufacturer that they have made in here two bolts holes, first, second, and this is standard bolt what goes in that hole. Then I only little bit rotate that, and best bolt is something like this bolt size, and length could be a little bit longer, because now I have issue that I don't have this specific length bolt, but let's look that how this my bolt works. And there is a little bit longer. First I need to rotate these bolts in these holes. Okay. And that one also. Okay, now they are in there, and then we need friends. We start to rotate that. There are some
Maybe this might pull this. Okay, because now there is issue that this might bolt don't work, but I use then this only one bolt. There is idea that then I start to rotate that's my bolt in this way. And idea is that when this bolt goes in there deeper, it same time moves this room away. And we need to rotate that sometimes same amount what is this bolt length, what is like 1 inch or something like 2 to 3 centimeters. And now I rotate that, and now this my room is moving. And it is good if we have 2 bolts in same time that we can rotate these bolts easily. Now I have only that bolt, and now I can move that in this way, and then when this is enough, I change that my bolt in this second hole. And now I have situation that bolt drops, but I insert that in here. That way, good. And then I rotate that. And now it's... And suddenly we can feel that, hey, now this is loosened. Now we can see that this moves nicely. And... Okay, let's look at... And sometimes this drum makes sound. Okay. And it is good to use so that we have 2 bolts, because now this work is little bit slow, because I need to change that my bolt in side by side, but this is the idea. Okay, now I rotate in here. And better, and then suddenly this room opens. And if we need longer bolts, we need to purchase longer bolts that we can take this room away. And this is this idea. Okay, good. And now we have take that room away, and room looks like that. And then we can continue our job. Hello and welcome, and next I am planning to show you that how to replace this Toyota Camry cars, this rear areas, these bearings. And now this my video is not yet starting, because this is like only this intro part, but idea is to replace this central hoop, and there inside are those rear bearings. Okay, and then we start this job, and first step is of course to take this feel bolts away, and we start to take this our feel next away, that you can see all of those parts, and then we continue. Okay, and next part is to take this central hoop away, because then we can work in here more easily. And for that job we need socket that we can take this part away, and then we continue. Okay, and there is now inside 3, 4 bolts what I need to open, and let's go to look what they looks like, because it is easier. And there we can see that there is 1 bolt in there. And then when I insert this my tool in that way, now this bolt is in position. And in that step I can open this bolt, and I need next socket what size is 14 millimeter, 1 4 is this socket what fits in there, and then I need also a little bit longer bar that I can open those. Okay, and then I have this longer bar, what is in here, it is quite long. I insert this my socket in there, now it's in position. Now I check that is this really in there. If we have liked, it is easier to locate these bolts, and this is first one. And I open it in that way that I insert this my tool in here. And then it's good to look a little bit longer that we can get this idea. There is my tool. And then when I rotate that part, and then I only, this is a little bit tight, but no worry, now it's moving. And then it's good to open all of these bolts, and when we rotate that hole, we can easily see these bolts. There is next one. And then these bolts opens easily, because these parts are Toyota quality, and these parts last really long time. Maybe, I believe that maybe 50 years. They are so well made. And then there is this next one, third bolt. And I open also that first. Okay, and now it's my socket went in there. No worry, I believe that I can take it out. And interesting, now it drops in there. Okay, and I need to take my tongs next. Okay, and now there is a situation that my socket, I made mistake, and my socket drops in there inside. It is not very far away, but it is difficult to take now out, and it's good to be carefully that we don't take similar mistake. But I am lucky because I have a spare part socket, and maybe I can open this last bolt in here, because otherwise, and then I check. Okay, and there is this bolt, and now I insert the tool in there, and now I hope that I can open this final bolt, even that I have a short tool. Now we can check that what happens when we have very small tools. There is risk that this tool goes broken. Okay, and now there is really... Okay, now, yes, I was lucky, because I managed to open that tight bolt using only small wrench, but it is not... Now I am more carefully, that I don't drop my sockets in there inside. And now when I rotate, I manage to take first of these bolts away. And there is first bolt. And then I continue my job. I come back in here, and now I use only my fingers. And now my purpose is to take all of these four bolts away. This is second. Okay. Okay, this is second similar bolt, and then I rotate that in here down, and I open that down bolt also. Okay, now it opens, and then the final one. There is this final. Final bolt. Okay, and now all of these four bolts are free. And then when these bolts are free, this part normally opens very easily in that way. And now this hoop carrier is free, and there inside we can see those bearings also. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and then when we have purchased this new hoop carrier, we can install that in same way back in here. In that way it goes, note that there are those bolt locations and it is a little bit different, and this part becomes up, and we only install that in here in that way, and then we install those bolts back next. Okay, and then I take this central hoop, and this goes in that way, the inner. There is important to check that these holes goes through in same areas in there. And then I take this my bolt, my socket and 14 millimeter. Then I start to install that in here. Then when bolts start to move, we are in right position. And if they don't, we need to readjust this. That's our setting a little bit. And if we have light, we can check with light that how these bolts are in there inside. Well, I need to move a little bit in there. Okay, and now I check that how now these bolts goes in there. Now it went nicely, excellent. Okay, and first bolt I insert in that way, and then I insert next bolt in that area. This area is also okay. And I check that all bolts goes nicely. It went. Then next one. There. Bolt drops. Okay. It goes on also nicely. Okay, cool. And then I take this final fourth bolt, and it goes nicely, good. And now all bolts are in there, good. And then I do this first pre-tightening. There's my tool, and now I tighten this little bit, not too much, only that they are well in there, not too much force. Because next I need to take my torque wrench tool and here, and now bolts are fine, and then I take my torque wrench tool that we can insert these bolts in very well in there. Okay, and here is this my torque reference tool, and now this force is about 80 to 90 newton meters. I change this my tool, and I start in here, and then when we hear this click, we have enough force, and then another side. Okay, there is enough, and then this one in here, 80 to 90 newton meters, and this is
then I check that everything is fine.
Okay, everything is fine. And then I install this break room in there. But before of that, I clean carefully this break juice. There is no any dirties. Clean cotton cloth and so much that there is no any that cotton is clean. If there's any dirties, take new cotton cloth. Okay, and now I think that this is fine, and then I take this break room. Okay, and then I take this break room, and this goes in that way. We only look these bolts and then these holes, and in carefully it goes in paper, and then we check that is this room this rotation nice, because this must be in that kind of movement. If this is stuck, then we have made mistake, and if this is stuck, we need to adjust that adjusting bolt in here. When we rotate that in down, then this brake juice becomes bigger, and then in another direction juice becomes smaller, and then we can adjust that movement. Okay, good. And now this job is almost ready, and final part is to install feel back, and then everything is fine. And thank you for watching, and have a nice day to you.